हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ कोड डिवीजन मल्टीपल एक्सेस। इन कोड डिवीजन मल्टीपल एक्सेस मीन्स इन CDMA ओनली वन चैनल कैरियर इज़ यूज टू ट्रांसमिट द ऑल्ट ट्रांसमिशन। मीन्स अ CDMA इज़ डिफर फ्रॉम द FDMA बिकॉज ओनली वन चैनल इज ऑक्यूपाई इन दिस वन इन CDMA। Or it is differ from the TDMA because in CDMA all the station send the data simultaneously without time sharing. Means in FDMA we are using the different channels for the different users, but here we are using the only one channel for all the users. And a TDMA, in TDMA a data will be sent in different frames and it is a discontinuous, but in CDMA data will send simultaneously without time sharing. Code division multiple access in this the different codes are used for each and every user. So one mobile station differ from other with the help of the code, and base station or any station, mobile to mobile or base station to mobile station, can be exchange the data in the form of code. So here three dimensional figure shows on x axis there is a frequency, on y axis there is a code, and z axis there is a time. So time and the frequencies remain same, while only codes are changes with respect to the channels, which different codes are to be used for the different users. This can be explained with the help of this diagram. Suppose on the x axis there is a frequency or y axis there is a users. So in code division multiple access, each and every users will give a different code. Means code 1 is used for the user 1, code 2 is used for the user 2, code 3 is used for the user 3, code 4 is for the user 4. Means different codes are assigned for the different users. Our explanation can also be more elaborated with the help of this diagram. See, in the CDMA, suppose there are the four stations that are D1, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, in which D1 is the original signal for the station 1, and station 1 data is D1, means the message signal is D1, is mixed with the code C1 and transmitted in the common channel as a D1C1. Likewise, a station 2 whose message signal is D2 and mixed with the another code, that is the C2, forms D2C2 signal and will be transmitted over the transmitter. And likewise, station 4 and station 3 and station 4 use D3C3 and D4C4 data for transmitting, and at the receiver this C1, C2, C3, C4 with respect to the station data 1, data 2, data 3 and data 4 is removed, and only a message signal will be received at the receiver. Working of the CDMA. In CDMA, a slow spreading signal, a slow information signal, that is a message signal, mixed with the, here a mixer is there, mixed with the fast spreading signal. There is a difference between the slow information signal and the fast spreading signal, where the fast spreading signal having the higher frequency, that is a cheap rate of the fast spreading signal is very high as compared to the input signal. And that signal will be mixed at the transmitter, and signal that as the signal we are mixing from the message signal and the code signal, that is a fast spreading signal and the slow message signal, बिकॉज स्लो मिसिंग सिग्नल इज नथिंग बट द सो इन्फॉर्मेशन स्लो इन्फॉर्मेशन सिग्नल इज नथिंग बट द मैसेज सिग्नल हुज फ्रिक्वेंसी इज लेस एज कम्पेयर टू द फास्ट स्प्रेडिंग सिग्नल एंड एट अ मिक्सर वी आर मिक्सिंग द टू सिग्नल the transmitter will transmit that signal. Whatever the signal is transmitted from the transmitter is a wideband signal because it mixes the two signals. So it forms the wideband. And this wideband is transmitted at the receiver, transmitter to receiver. And at the receiver, it receives the wideband signal. And whatever a mixing is applied at the transmitter, a reverse process of the mixing will be applied at the receiver, where the fast spreading signal will be removed here, removed from the original signal, so that at the receiver only a message signal will be received at the receiver. This is the working of CDMA. Here, a data signal whose frequency is very less as compared to the fast spreading signal, that is a pseudo-random signal or a code signal. And these are XORed together with the help of the signal. Means a mixer can be a addition or multiplication or XOR. Any things can be happen with the message signal and a pseudo random signal. Here we are XORing the two signals so that whatever the signal are to be made, it is called as the wide band signal. And this signal will be transmitted over the transmitter and at the receiver. This signal is received at the receiver, and from the receiver pseudo code will be removed so that only a original signal will be received at the receiver. Okay, in CDMA system, narrow band message signal is multiplied with the large band signal called as a spread signal, because we are adding the two signal, we are mixing the two signal. One is a message signal and other is a pseudo random signal, that is a spread signal. This spreading signal is nothing but the PN signal. The another name for the spreading signal or fast spreading sequence or the code is also a PN sequence, pseudo random code sequence, whose chip rate is larger than that of the data rate of the message. CDMA uses the same frequency for all the user at the same time. In CDMA, only one frequency is to be used for multiple users with the same time slot. CDMA contains pseudo random code. Receiver perform the time correlation function so that the signal appear uncorrelated. Here, as we are mixing a code to the original message, but at the receiver cannot be understood which one is the code and which one is the message signal. And however, a receiver should know the code word to decrypt the message signal. At the receiver, a same process, that is we are adding at the transmitter for the PN sequence and the message signal, a reverse process, exactly reverse process will be applied at the receiver so that we can remove the code from the message and only a message signal will be received at the receiver, so that a decrypt signal should be used at the receiver. Capacity of the CDMA can be explained with the help of following formula. That is, number of the users can access the system is N is equal to 1 plus W by R divided by EB by N. N0 minus eta by S, where W by R is a process gain, N is the background thermal noise, S is the power of each user, and N is the number of users, and EB by N0 is a signal to noise ratio. There is a problem in the CDMA called near far problems. So what is mean by the near far problems? See, in this diagram, suppose there is a base station and a base station is a receiver, whereas a two mobile station as a transmitter. One is very nearer to the receiver, means a base station, and one is very far away from the base station. So we know that as we are moving from the base station, its signal level decreases. So it can be differ with the help of diagram. Because of a transmitter, mobile station 1, it is near to the base station, its received signal is higher. Its received signal higher than whatever the signal we are received by the mobile station 2. It's very less, a received signal is very less as compared to the mobile station received at mobile station 1 received at the base station. So a near far effect means that as a transmitted power is equal from the base station, as we are moving from the base station, means as a distance from the base station will be increases, the receiving power is decreases also. It is inverse square law says that as we are moving from the base station, more and more noise will be added. So received signal is very less. So when a simultaneously mobile station 1 and mobile station 2 is transmitted the signal towards the receiver, then receiver will receive the maximum signal first, then that of the lesser signal or the weak signal. So in some cases, the message from the mobile station 2 may be will not catch by the base station, and only a signal that is higher signal or the strong signal from the mobile station will be catch when the two signals is coming at the base station equally, so that it receive the higher signal than that of the weaker signal. That is nothing but the near far problems, and that is affected in the CDMA. Then a comparison between the TDMA, CDMA and FDMA. FDMA, TDMA, CDMA. Long form of FDMA, time division multiple access, frequency division multiple access, time division multiple access, code division multiple access. In this, sharing of the bandwidth among the different station takes place. Sharing of the bandwidth means only one frequency will be used. In this, sharing of the time slot amongst the different station, and in this, only one signal is to be used, and one signal can be used to share the different user with the different time slot. There is no need of any code word. Here also no need of code word, but in the code CDMA, code word is necessary. Then FDMA, there is only need a guard band between the adjacent channel necessary. In this, guard time of adjacent slot is necessary. In CDMA, both guard band and guard time is necessary. And synchronization is not required, as we are discontinuous in the transmission. In the TDMA, synchronization is required. Here, no synchronization is needed. The rate of the data is low as compared to the TDMA, CDMA. The data rate is medium and the data rate is high in the CDMA as compared to both. Mode of data transfer is continuous. Here also, a mode of the transmission of the signal in the here in the FDMA, mode of the data transfer is continuous signal only. Here, a mode of the data signal is a burst. Burst means nothing but the slots. Different slots are to be used for the transmitting the data of the different users. Mode of the data transfer is digital signal. It is little flexible, the moderate flexible or high flexible. Filtering is the frequency domain. Synchronization in the time domain. Code plus special code is received. Okay, thank you.